The new fallout this morning over the decision to pull 6 Dr. Seuss books from publication because of racist and insensitive imagery.
So, the gist of it is that the publishing company that manages Dr. Seuss's intellectual property is no longer publishing those 6 books.
Tonight, conservatives blaming cancel culture after Dr. Seuss Enterprises announced 6 of the famed author's books will no longer be published because of offensive imagery.
Racism in art has been everything but rare, making the world worse and making it unfair, dehumanizing people to justify hate, making them others so with them we can't relate. This has been the topic on the news as of late, finding racist images in culture up to date. A children's author was exposed and put to shame. You know him, he's famous. Dr. Seuss is his name. 6 of his books won't ever be reprinted because of the way some people were depicted. Look at the 1950 book I Ran the Zoo. I find this unacceptable. I hope you do too. The way he drew those men is racist and absurd. They're made to look like animals. They look just like the bird. Or look at this 1929 bitter cartoon. That makes Dr. Seuss look like a true racist buffoon. Drawing black people as a form of commodity, that's the kind of joke that encourages bigotry. And to think that I saw it on Mulberry Street, are Asians also people that we can mistreat? Is Dr. Seuss racist? Let's look at what he said. Here's how during World War II, Dr. Seuss was quoted. This quote is racist and these are the facts. If we want to win, we've got to kill Japs. But often Dr. Seuss could be anti-racist. Against Hitler, he was a propagandist. America First was against intervention. They thought America shouldn't fight Nazi expansion. Unrelated by blood, they are joined, the accusation. Not fighting Nazism to Seuss was treason. And what about his 1953 book, The Sneetches? Anti-segregation, unity is what it teaches. Was Dr. Seuss racist? Yes, he was, without a doubt. But sometimes racism is not what we thought. To be a racist, you don't need to hate or have malice. Racists aren't all sadists, heinous, vicious. You can still be racist without hating non-white people. The ways that this can happen are quite plentiful. Dr. Seuss maybe didn't hate black Americans, but his images certainly contributed to their systemic oppression. Most people are racists without wanting it to happen, and learning that you're racist can sure be triggering. Learning to be less racist is sure not easy. Learn to recognize and tear down white supremacy.
I feel like I often say this, but this video was quite different, and I hope you enjoyed it. All I wanted to do is to remind you that you don't need a Nazi armband or a Klansman hood to be a racist. You simply need to contribute to white supremacy. And we all do that to some extent. We just need to identify it and fight it. Personally, I think it's a great thing that these 6 books were taken off the market. We obviously don't want to spread, nor do we want to normalize these images. And we can now read Dr. Seuss without worrying about them. Anyway, thank you for watching the video, thank you for liking and subscribing if you have already, and I'd also like to thank You Design I Write, Kohler, and every other patron for supporting the channel. If you also want to help out, check out patreon.com/thecanvas.